Okay, so we'll now see some important results which had we'll build upon those results which we had seen in the previous video. So we had seen the impulse response, step response, and discussed some other terms. So firstly we'll see the Bode plot. So again, Bode plot has two aspects, the dB magnitude and the phase aspect. So dB magnitude, again we can draw the asymptotes. So this is the transfer function, and substituting s equal to j omega. So now dB magnitude is 20 log mod of h of omega. So note that there's an omega n square here. So we'll consider two cases, omega very less than omega n and omega greater than omega n. So for very small values we'll get the dB magnitude to be 0, since this goes to 1, and for higher magnitudes we'll get again an asymptote 40. So there's an omega n square, so that would give 40 log omega n, and the dominant factor would be minus log omega. So these are the asymptotes. So we see from 0 to omega n it would trace 0 or close to 0, and beyond that it would trace a straight line with slope minus 40, so with respect to x-axis being log omega. And similarly, we plot the phase using the argument relation, and we get this curve. So we see that at omega equal to omega n, it's the value of the phase is minus 90. So this is consistent with the relation. Now we'll see some other aspects regarding the step response. So we had discussed the general relation of the step, which included the exponential decaying plus the sinusoid. So this is the plot for a given omega n and a given choice of zeta. So we'll define some things. So first is the overshoot. So overshoot is defined as the maximum deviation of the peak from the value 1 in case of step response. So that's usually it is expressed in percentage term. So this may be around 50% overshoot. So again, settling time, this is similar to the first order we had discussed. So in the previous video we had seen that what T did for first order, the equivalent term is 1 by zeta omega n. So again, to get the 2% settling time, we said that for first order we had 4 T. Now we'll have 4 zeta, 4 by zeta and omega n, omega 4 by zeta omega n. So again, the settling times can be calculated based on the percentage requirement. So this is the band between which after which after the time which the value would remain between 2% error with respect to the steady state. So other term is the rise time. So rise time is defined as the time where the curve first hits the 1. So in case of step response, since the steady value would be 1, so it is the first the minimum time at which the curve would hit 1. So that is represented as TR. Now some mathematical calculation suggests the values of TR, TS and the overshoot magnitudes. So we'll directly use the results and see if on following those methods if we get a correct answer. So firstly we'll see rise time. So effect of zeta and omega n on rise time. So this suggests that here the omega d is omega n times 1 minus zeta square. So this suggests that on increasing zeta, so the denominator would decrease, and hence we'd expect that on increasing zeta the rise time would increase. So we'll see if it follows. Then the settling time we had discussed, it's 4 by zeta omega n. So again, on increasing zeta we'd expect the rise time to decrease, and the again omega overshoot is mathematically computed as this. Now here we see if we for a given omega, if we increase the zeta, so the numerator increases, denominator decreases, so overall it increases. So e to the power minus a bigger value would be smaller. So hence we'd expect that on increasing the value of zeta, the overshoot should decrease. Now we'll see if it holds true indeed. So we have plotted three Bode plots. for second order system of the form this. Just we have taken same omega, that is omega n, that is 1 radian per second, and just changed the zeta values and taken in increasing order 0.3, 0.5, 0.8 and the color code. So as we had guessed the rise time, so we had said that increasing zeta would decrease the value and increase the rise time. So that is indeed true, since the rise time for 0.3 was this around this value, and for yellow it would be around this value. So indeed it has indeed it has increased. So again another aspect would be the settling time. So it is clear from the plot, the blue plot takes a larger time to settle as compared to red or yellow, and in decreasing order. So again that is valid, since on increasing zeta we'd expect the settling time to decrease. And again the overshoot will we had seen that on increasing zeta the overshoot should decrease, and yeah, so that's also the case. So yeah, though the theoretical values is indeed observed, and again the Bode plot can be plotted for different values. So we'll see that the blue was for the least zeta, and yeah, so it had a larger M peak. So we'll discuss this in the control design part, and it has it also has a steeper change for the phase values. So in practical applications we'll see that we'll consider zetas between 0.6 to 0.8, and this that would give us that would help us to acquire certain conditions given in the control problem. Okay, thank you.